So, were you expecting me to start? Most people would have expected me to start based on my body language and what I said. Intention cues are a fundamental part of human communication. For example, to succeed in team sports, we need to know when our teammates are going to pass the ball or make a run. It is also true when one person's actions affects the safety of others. Like when we drive, it helps to know if a pedestrian intends to cross the road or if a driver intends to turn. That's why some eons ago, a smart person invented the indicators. Hi, I'm Mo. I'm a designer working on self-driving cars and road safety. My research focuses on how self-driving cars communicate their intended actions to you inside the car. Let's say you're in a car driven by your son or daughter. Now, you would not look at the way they're driving, but also you would observe them to see if they're aware of their surroundings. Are they going to slow down? Are they intending to give way? Now imagine you're in a car driven by an invisible driver. You would have no way of knowing what they're going to do next, right? People have tried verbal interfaces, graphical interfaces, and also showing what the car sees on the console screen. But imagine sitting in a car that constantly yaps on about what it intends to do next. Or a console screen or windshield cluttered with all sorts of information. Doesn't sound very appealing, does it? My research goes back to the fundamentals. It tries to understand how passengers interpret a driver's intentions. And to do that, we installed cameras everywhere in the car to record everything. Then we asked the passenger to note down all the times when they recognized the driver's intentions. Then, finally, in an interview, we played back those videos and asked them about it. We discovered many cool things. One passenger said when the driver had their hands on the 11 o'clock position on the steering wheel, this surely meant they're going to turn right. But what made it more interesting was that if the turn was far away, it confused the passenger. Additionally, if there were no head checks to look for oncoming traffic, it made the passenger feel unsafe. For the passenger to be satisfied, all these cues had to be present before a turn. Now, self-driving cars are emerging, but the feeling of safety and comfort for us to let them drive still has a ways to go. My research paves the way to visualize that invisible driver through understanding how human drivers communicate their intentions.